Hi everybody, myself Shiva Shankar. I have appointed newly as an English teacher for you. In this session, dear students, I am going to discuss about a poem called Beauty. Before going to start this poem, I would like to ask you a question. What is beauty? Beauty means it is something attractive and feel better to the mind. Whenever we see beautiful things, suddenly we feel better and pleasant to the mind. That is called beauty. Let us begin the first stanza. Beauty is seen in the sunlight. We can see beauty in the sunlight. Whenever we see the sunlight, we enjoy the brightness of the sunlight. That brightness shows beautiful things of the nature. We can see beautiful atmosphere in the trees, in the birds. We might have seen beautiful birds. Whenever we see colorful birds, we feel very happy. And whenever we see different kinds of trees, we feel very happy and better. Corn growing and people are working or dancing for their harvest. You know, during the time of harvest time, harvest means it is a type of seasonable one. During the harvest time, people are working in the field. Here corn means it is a kind of craft. How the people are working in the field by dancing together and singing together. This intensifies beauty of the human being. How the people are enjoying in the field, especially during the time of harvest. Next one, beauty is heard in the night. We can hear the beauty, especially in the night. In the night, we can see so many stars and moon. There is a peaceful atmosphere in the night. If you are really keen observer, you can hear the sound of the wind, especially in the rainy season, how the wind is sighing. And rain falling, especially during the time of rainy season, totally the atmosphere has been changed. You might have experienced. During the time of rainy season, many children want to escape from their houses because they want to enjoy in the rain. Or a singer chanting anything in earnest. During the time of rainy season, some people start sing a song. How they sing a song? Chanting means here singing a song in a rhythmic way. Singing a song is totally different from sing a song in a rhythmic way. People start singing a song in a rhythmic way, especially during the time of rainy season. In this stanza, the poet discusses about external beauty of the nature. Let us move on to the last stanza. Beauty is in yourself, good deeds, happy thoughts that repeat themselves in your dreams, in your work and even in your rest. Beauty is in yourself. You know, you might have seen so many beautiful things around you. But ultimately, beauty is within you. How we represent beauty? Good deeds means, work. By doing good deeds, good works, we can represent beauty. Happy thoughts. Happy thoughts means every day we have to use happy things. We have to speak very systematic manner. For example, whenever we meet a strange people, he may be friend, he may be anything. We have to use, like, you know, thank you, congratulations, many more happy returns of the day. Such words we have to use in our day-to-day life. Those thoughts help in our day-to-day life. That repeat themselves in our dreams, in our work. In our dreams also, there must be a goodness. You have to dream yourselves, according to Abdul Kalam, one must have big aim. We should not stick on a particular aim. Your dream also should be very great. Then only you can lead a very beautiful life. And in your work also, every day we have to work honestly. If you are really honestly work in your day-to-day life, definitely you can enjoy the beauty of the life. So that is the also kind request from a poet to everyone. And even in your rest. Rest means, meditation. When you are, every day you have to do meditation. In the meditation also, you have to get something, pleasure, something peaceful. That peaceful also intensifies beautiful. So if you follow all these things in your day-to-day life, definitely your life will become golden. I mean, your life will become very beautiful. Beauty is existed everywhere. In each and every object of the nature, we can see beauty. That is why there is a beautiful saying in English, beauty lies in the eyes of beholder. So that beauty is existed everywhere. Beauty existed today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow. It remains forever. Okay, with this, I will conclude the poem. Thank you for listening this poem.